Good evening, everyone. It is a proud and privileged moment for all of us at the Observer Research Foundation to once again welcome dear young and dynamic Chief Minister of Maharashtra, Honorable Shri Devendra Fadnavis today. Sir, we have had the great honor of welcoming you twice earlier, and it is enormously encouraging for us to have your continued support. It means the world to all of us at Dhaval Desai. I now request Shri Subhendra Kulkarni to welcome the Honorable Chief Minister with flowers. And sir, before you do the honors and release of a report, kindly allow me to give you a brief snapshot of the Observer Research Foundation and the kind of work that you have been doing. Since 2010, ORF Mumbai, under the leadership of Shri Subhendra Kulkarni, Chairman, has primarily focused on issues of local and national significance. Since 2010, we have produced over 80 research reports and organized over 350 events, each carefully planned and executed to create an informed debate and help the government at the city and the state levels to arrive at informed decisions. The following few slides will give you a glimpse of some of our work on critical challenges that confront Mumbai and Maharashtra. One of our earlier reports was on Mumbai's Mithi River, which is also authored by Gautam, who is the co-author of today's report too. And this report received great acclaim from all quarters and inspired the then MMRDA commissioner to ask us to take up a study on the transformation of the Maharashtra Nature Park, which abuts the Mithi and is sandwiched between the sprawls of Dharavi on the one side and the Bandra Kurla complex across the river, two of the most diverse and economically disparate landmarks of the city. MMRDA subsequently invited ORF Mumbai to become its knowledge partner for a global design competition for the makeover of the Maharashtra Nature Park, the MNP, which also includes a pedestrian and cyclist-only bridge across the Mithi River, connecting Dharavi and BKC. The global design competition, sir, has been won by a Mumbai-based consortium, but there has been very little progress on the project after that. And we are expecting the MMRDA to soon sign the contract for the proposed makeover and the bridge construction. There are some of our other reports on the issues of municipal water management and distribution and rainwater harvesting, on open spaces and parks policy of the MCGM, slum rejuvenation. And so this is important, as efforts towards slum redevelopment and rehabilitation have mostly failed to get the desired results, and there actually are more slums today than when the SRA was launched in 1996. So we have also done some meaningful work in the space of public transport, specifically for Mumbai Suburban Railway, which caters to a commuter traffic of nearly 80 lakh daily, but which also sadly accounts for the loss of 8 to 10 innocent lives daily. So please allow me to emphasize that the issue of suburban railway is one where we need your direct help and support in bringing the issues to the notice of the Railway Ministry in New Delhi. We are certain that some of our recommendations, such as the unification of the Central and the Western Railway into a single zone for Mumbai Suburban Railway under the Indian Railway, and the Saral timetable, will bring tremendous relief to the people of Maha Mumbai, and which actually translates into 80 lakh votes if one looks at it from the angle of political gains. And through our Mahatma Gandhi Center for Sanitation, Cleanliness and Community Health, we at ORF have also tirelessly studied the challenges of sanitation, particularly sanitation in slums, and public health and sustainable development. Our report on mapping the solar rooftop PV potential of Mumbai, jointly published with IIT Bombay, estimates the rooftop potential of the city to be around 1.7 gigawatt, which can go a long way in making Mumbai a green energy city and also show the way forward to the rest of urban India to achieve the objectives of the Prime Minister's Solar India Mission. Our publication, India at 70, recommends a grand vision for the restoration of two iconic landmarks of Mumbai, ironically, both open public spaces for which we have gathered today, both the open spaces which played a significant role in India's freedom struggle, the Azad Maidan and the August Kranti Maidan. It is a shame, sir, that these two iconic Maidans
which in any other country would have been national monuments, are in a pitiable condition because of civic apathy and public neglect. So one of our ambitious initiatives has been the creation of Friends of Mumbai University platform, a voluntary, non-profit, non-political and global multi-stakeholder association of the alumni, well-wishers, students and teachers, both retired and serving of the University of Mumbai and all its affiliated colleges. Our objective is to help the university, which has entered its 160th year in 2017, regain its lost glory and become one among the top 100 universities in the world. Sir, we are very happy to share with you that the Friends of Mumbai University campaign has received the full backing of the Governor of Maharashtra, who is also the Chancellor of all the state universities. And this campaign has already achieved early success, with ORF Mumbai playing a catalytic role for the upgradation of the university's Department of Economics, India's oldest Department of Economics, to the Mumbai School of Economics and Public Policy. And ORF Mumbai, sir, has also been instrumental in getting your government to announce a grant of Rs. 25 crore in its budget for the current financial year for the MSc and PP. The school will work as a think tank for your government. Through the Maharashtra Adhyayan Kendra, an important initiative of ORF Mumbai that looks at the challenges confronting India's most progressive state, we have published our comprehensive report on drought in Marathwada, which we are delighted was also released by you. We are also working as a knowledge partner for your Ministry of Finance for the preparation of a vision and roadmap for the establishment of the Gondwana University, an integrated modern tribal university in the Gadchiroli district. I will end my remarks by once again extending our heartfelt gratitude to you and with a picture of you performing the puja at Kushavart in Trimbakeshwar on the occasion of the unique occasion of India-China holy water diplomacy. Thank you very much for being there for us, sir. I'll now invite my colleague and co-author of this report, Endangered Open Spaces of Mumbai, Saili Mankekar, to give you a brief snapshot of the report itself. Thank you very much.